Good morning. Thank you for catching another episode of Jen and Juice Live. It's so fun how these videos have started. I was just juicing and showing you guys my morning routine and what I've done to make me well. And then you started asking great questions and we've kind of turned it into being able to talk about topics that come up during the week from other videos or my blog post or Instagram post or whatever questions that you guys have. So today, the title of this video is Sometimes I Still Hate My Body. Hey, Nikki, thanks for joining on. And sometimes I still hate my body. And even living symptom-free and symptomless and having come through this several-year healing journey of autoimmune disease and really coming to a really good spot in my health and in my life, there are days that are still really tough and I hate my body. And this has come up especially around the holidays. I've had this conversation with so many of you, so many of my clients, my friends, and I want to tell you what happened to me on Thanksgiving this year and why I still struggle with some body shame or some expectations of my body that I just don't really feel like are fair and realistic. So this year on Thanksgiving, we did the same thing that we normally do, eat the same foods. I love Thanksgiving. It's my favorite holiday. I love the people we get together with. I love the food that we make. It's awesome. And this year I just piled up on my plate what I normally eat and poured some wine in my glass and I started eating. And these foods that I chose are something that last year I literally ate the same thing. But right away I started to feel kind of like I was getting a headache and then a little bit sweaty. And I was like, oh, definitely the meat sweats. Cause I don't eat a whole lot of meat, but I definitely enjoyed the several of the like six or seven meats that we had on hand on Thanksgiving. So I started eating and I wasn't feeling very well. And I was like, oh, okay, just not what my body's used to. I'm used to a lot of living foods and not a lot of meat. And on my plate, I had a lot of awesome roasted dishes and sweet potatoes and vegetables and all different kinds of meat. But I also had pork and I had wine. And those are two things that I tell my clients. And this isn't about like what to eat and what not to eat. I'm just telling you my experience. So those are two things I tell my clients in healing periods to avoid, because pork, we know scientifically it's not a super clean animal to eat, and we know it's not always beneficial to our bodies. And then wine, well, the NIH considers it a human carcinogen, and any alcohol, so carcinogen, sorry. And you gotta think about what you're putting in your body. Well, I think I've come to a point in my healing journey that my body has been so detoxed and cleaned on a cellular level that it really rejects anything that it doesn't see as productive. So I didn't feel very good after I ate. I had a headache and just kind of felt like instantly my vibration lowered. And I thought that was really interesting. So, but I was able to carry on through the rest of the holiday and hang out with family and friends, and everything was great. But this is where it gets interesting. It was several hours later when I was at home, I felt my stomach started to really, really hurt. And I was like, I just want to go to sleep forever. Like, that's what I felt like. So I laid down, but my body was like, nope, you got to get up and go to the bathroom. And if you have a weak stomach, I won't get too into detail, but I was so sick. And not like, I thought, okay, like stomach flu, but nope. And we'll go on later to know that I was fine. Food poisoning, everybody else ate the same things as me and they were fine. My body violently rejected what I ate. I was throwing up so forcefully that I've never had an experience like it. And what's really interesting, and it was several, like 10 times in an hour, to the point, you know, where you're not even throwing anything up, just like acid and bile, and it hurts and sucks. And I was literally crying for it to stop. And afterwards, and I'm a very spiritual person, and I just had a bunch of scripture come to mind, and I took a nap on the bathroom floor. And when I woke up from that nap, I was like, there's a big lesson here, and my body and my spirit are trying to teach me something. So some things that came to mind when I was vomiting in the toilet, that, you know, our bodies, we cannot separate our body and our spirit. And this whole healing journey has been so spiritual for me. I've learned a ton. I know that we all are on this earth because for a reason, for a purpose. And in order for me to fulfill my purpose, I have to live a certain way and I have to operate at a certain vibration and be, you know, at a certain level of health to carry out my mission and my purpose in the world. And my body likes to remind me of that. My body loves to remind me when I'm out of alignment with my food, with my sleep, with my thoughts, with my relationships. My body will show me and it will tell me. So what I was thinking when I, or things that were coming to mind when I was getting sick and then kind of laying there after and recovering, is that we are called to live in this world but not be of this world. So if you feel like, you know, you have a mission, a purpose, you're a light worker, or you know, you're a disciple and you're here for a reason and you have something that you need to fulfill, then you're going to have to treat your body different than the world treats it. If you, and for me, that's where I hated my body and had that body shame of like, well, why can't my body just do what everybody else does and eat what everybody else eats? And I'm finally to this point that I'm like, no, I don't think I want that. And my body is the normal one. My body knows what it was created to eat, drink, breathe, think, how it was created to live. And it's not to be like this society. I don't want to be another American health statistic. And I don't want to operate at the level of, I think most of our world is. A lot of us are living numbed out on, you know, food and drink choices, and spiritually we're numbed out and we are just kind of moseying our way through life. And that's how I was before I got sick. I didn't realize the thoughts that I was consuming and the things I was putting in my body. And so I'm really, really thankful at this point. And I've come full circle after meditating and reflecting on my Thanksgiving experience of what happened in my body. And I can hate my body and I can fight it, or I can say thank you, body, for reminding me when I'm not in alignment with my purpose and my path, and when I'm putting things in my body that are, you know, decreasing my vibration and putting me just in another really like state of being that is not productive to why I need to be here. And I'm not saying none of us will ever be perfect. I definitely won't be. But I know that there is definitely a reason, and I think my soul works through my body because we can't separate the two on this earth, to remind me that I can't be like the rest of the world, and that's okay. And I know that so many of the people I work with now, if you're having intense, I mean, an IgE food mediated response, so if like you're having an allergic reaction to food and it's like you can't breathe, that's one thing. If it's a severe IgG reaction, you know, you smell gluten, or you know, have a taste of it and you're in bed for several days, that is something that is to be worked on and healed in your body. But what I'm talking about is things that you can't eat like everyone else, and that's okay. And that means like when there's a pizza party that you just say, no thanks, I'm here to enjoy you guys. And what is more important, hurting someone's feelings, pleasing someone, or taking care of your body so that you can serve and you can love and you can lead in your life and you can show up for your mission and the people in your life? So I think around the holidays, it's super easy to just think, well, you know, I've done all this healing work and all this detoxing and my body's to a really good strong point, and I'll just kind of throw all my intentions out the window. But think about it. How do you want to feel the next day? And do you want to be able to continue on with your purpose and your mission right after that meal? And what is more important to you, spending the time with your family and friends and being intentional in the holidays and keeping on your path and hitting the ground running in 2020 with your goals and with you, with the reasons you're here to serve and love, or, you know, appeasing someone or just hurting someone's feelings and saying, no, thank you. You know, I know like loved ones, they really want to serve you with the dishes that they make, but just tell them that your goals and what you want. And if you know you have, you know, red light foods and green light foods, and just stay away from them if you don't feel like going through the body hate and the shame and that whole process that the holidays can bring on. So I just wanted to share my story with you. And if you want to read in detail about what I'm talking about, what happened to my body on Thanksgiving, how I was hating my body and felt a ton of shame, and now I've come full circle to appreciate and understand the spiritual lesson that was behind me getting sick. So that's on my blog, middaypigeon.com. You can see the link is in my Instagram bio, and then on Facebook, I will post the link as well. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And for next week, send me messages, comment, and we can talk about next week's content. Thanks.